At this time, we ask that you turn your attention to the player tunnel forming on the field. Every year, the Pinnacle Girls Lacrosse Club is proud to have student-athletes who represent Pinnacle High School through their hard work, both on the field and in the classroom. Each student-athlete has contributed to the history and tradition of this proud club, and we would like to honor 11 graduating seniors for their hard work and dedication to the program.
Number 46 is a Shamber.
Next up on attack in 50, Bryn Davis! She's accompanied tonight by her mother and father. Let's hear it for number 50, Bryn Davis! Next up on JV attack, number 90, Kayla! She's joined tonight by her mother and father. Make some noise for number 90, Kayla. Now for our final graduating senior at midfield and varsity captain, number 99. And she is joined tonight by her mother and father. Give some love to number 99.
Where's
Izzy Kaboom! And then, friends, I present to you your 2024 graduating senior!
Yeah.
side. Trying to tiptoe the sideline. Shot on goal. Another senior in the cage here for Pinnacle, Izzy Schimber. Also having a great season. 83 saves coming in. Make it 84. She stops this free position, gets the ball, going to clear it out.
Transition.
Schomburg up to Ella Wambacher. Foul called on Novak for checking the sphere. Novak continues to pressure. Wambacher passes back to Amber. Pushed out, turns around, with the spin move, gets Aztecs on the board. Settling things out on a slow break here. Looking for that look inside. Mel Hartley with a great work shot ball. Off the assist from Jess Amber. Going into the gap with two quick rolls. Just under 6 minutes to play here in the first.
Thank you.
game as Ella Wambacher brings it into the top of the fan, but tipped out. Lindsay Novak with a great take away. She flies across midfield. Start possession with the Aztecs. So we saw there was two legal checks, a legal check from Novak taking it out, but Hartley responds with a legal check of her own. So the ball is technically out on White, stays with the Aztecs. Wambacher goes left. Definitely had the look, but shot goes errant, wide right. Backed up by her sister, Grace Wambacher, bringing this back in for Corona. Sligo looking to set the pick on Novak, but she doesn't bite. Gets the check, and again, sinking his two players. Go, 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 go. hard. Slash call. Kenzie Novak. Yellow card of the evening. Aztecs set to restart play. Possession of Joseph Weigert, she passes up the field. Emma Humrick, the pass goes out of bounds, so turns back over to Savannah Souza. so far holding their own on the draw. Here against this high-powered Pinnacle team. Morales with the bob. Zaliga looking for the check, the call for in the sphere. Backs Lewis up to the 12-meter. This time, legal check from Saligo. Lopez comes in, picks up the ground ball. Let's see Hoskin to clear it out. Stick to the face here from Bren Davis. She'll take a yellow for that. Second yellow on Pinnacle tonight. Back on. In the face of Mara Escatel here. Seems to be okay. She's set up on the restart. Great sportsmanship from Pinnacle. You see Davis. Defensive play against Delaney McKeown, able to break up what would have been a quick shot. still able to hold on to it. Gieske comes in, pump fakes, gets the shooting space call. Roxy Hoskin in the cage defending. Gieske still able to sneak it by and find the back of the net.
Oh,
McKeon pulling in a great pass and gets the shot and goal. Great snag and finish here from McKeon. She gets her second of the night. Coming in. Over to Souza. bobbling the ball a bit. Able to work it around. Savannah Souza gets a hat trick. With that, we're at 10 goal differential, so we'll go to a running clock. Looks like the table hasn't quite caught on to that yet. But now they have, as the clock starts running. strong again for Pinnacle. Seniors has gotten on the board here tonight, except for, of course, is Shimber in the cage. and then number 11, Evelyn Vogel, and number 12, Kinsey Novak. Still just over a quarter to play. For a feed inside, and I think there was going to be a shooting space call, but instead Saligo takes the shot. Correction, I believe that's Melania Hartley going out on a yellow for the dangerous propel. Kiara Briggs on the restart. And actually looking like her legs are looking pretty good here as she comes up the near side. Nice linebacker with the takeaway. Linebacker spins, trying to find a way to get the shot off, not able to do so. And the clock hits zero. Pinnacle here in the third, 17-4. Hoskin, and she's injured. Of course, that was a rule change not too long ago. Goalies used to be required to wear shin guards. But of course, they are still required to have thigh protection, so that ball must have hit just a little low off the knee or shin. Certainly an option for goalies to continue to wear those pads, but most goalies decide not to. Of course, that's the risk they take when doing so. Battle for ground ball inside the eight here. Joe Saliga able to do a one-handed scoop. Fires a bounce shot, hits the right post, right back into the stick of Yuski, who gets the shooting space call, and she'll get the 8-meter free position shot. Fires a port right into the stick of Lexi Hoskin, who seems to be okay now. Chasing it down. Picking this up on the far side. Saliga comes over top and she's in the sphere. Thompson will continue with possession. She loses the ball. This time Saliga gets it clean. The Hartley is out of bounds. Varsity again at restart. Linebacker with the check. Picked up by Yuski. Passes over to Caputi. Check on the horizontal stick. Called against Lopez. So Delaney McEwen gets the free position, finds the bottom right corner. That's a hat trick for McEwen.
Thank you.
sinks it. Whistle prior to the shot. Might be a shooting space call as Caputi gets a chance from the top center hash.
Five on the board.